You guys have requested it. We're finally gonna do it. Best Friend, Yellow Wolf featuring Eminem. Let's get to it.
First impressions.
I really like the beat. I really like the beat. This is the first time that either of us are listening to this song right now. So that beat took me by surprise almost. I wasn't expecting
it. Yeah. The first little bit, the
pew. Yeah, yeah.
It actually went from this side.
It traveled, yeah.
Went that way.
I'm getting a very spacey or galactic vibe from it. Are you?
I can see.
Kinda.
More specifically, space cowboys.
Where are you getting the cowboys?
I don't know. The beat almost gives me Lone Rangers.
The guitar kind of is Wild West-y.
Yeah,
kinda.
Yeah.
So I can see that.
You guys requested this because of the saloon bit we did, didn't you?
Classic Slim Shady scratch. You hear the. Part where he says, I walk through hell almost every night, but I believe it's a pathway.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds to me like he's saying a pathway leads somewhere. So he's saying if he thinks hell is a pathway, he says to get to where you're going, you have to go through hell is the vibe I'm getting from it.
Yeah, that's huge.
Very biblical vibes from it.
Yeah, kind of. Yeah. You know what? People always say don't do anything you'll regret later. And getting a tattoo on your face, you'll definitely regret
later.
And so he says, with those tattoos on your face, say, boy, what are you doing? You'll pay the price.
If you keep doing that, you'll see what happens. You'll get what's coming.
You're not thinking shit through. Why would you get no regrets? Put tattooed on your chest. Do you know anything about Yellow Wolf?
Nothing.
I don't know what
I've heard of him. I haven't heard any of his music or anything. But, I mean, if all of his songs, Love Story, I haven't heard this album. But if Love Story, the rest of the album has this level of production, I'm down to, listen to it.
Do you know who Alan Raymond is?
No.
He's another artist, but he gives me very, calm Alan Raymond vibes. If you know who Alan Raymond vibes, you know exactly what I'm talking about. If you don't, look him up. He's sick. He's dope. I walk through hell almost every night. It's a pathway. Say, boy, what you doing with your life? With those tattoos on your face. Say, boy, you know that you'll pay the price. Well, I guess I'll see when I hit that way. To the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I hold you nearest, my best friend.
Let
the trumpets blow with your appearance. You don't lose hearing.
That's the chorus, I assume.
Yeah, that's the chorus.
That's a fire chorus.
I actually recognize the chorus.
From
something. Wow. I recognize it. I almost feel like I've heard this before now.
That's not the first time happened, though.
It could have definitely happened.
Okay, so I get it. Best Friend, the title of this, it's not actually a... It's he's talking about God,
yeah.
I assume, right?
So yeah, that's when you get the biblical...
Yeah, so I guess in that sense, the first verse really set up the...
Chorus?
Just the whole song, kind of, in general.
Yeah, it does.
Best Friend being Okay. Also, let the trumpets blow. We always have, was there trumpets there? I couldn't even hear
it. I couldn't hear it either, but I was listening to something else, actually.
What?
The snare. It goes, boom, 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 and then the second snare after that, it's the same pattern, but the snare is
almost delayed. Muffled. Oh. It's like muffled and like almost in the background. It's like boom,
boom, so every other snare is like loud?
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
And every other one is like muffled.
Maybe even a different snare.
To Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, like best friend, wish when you wish me hell upon my soul and spirit, behold these lyrics. I guess this is like a prayer song. Like, yeah. It's like
both a prayer and kind of like a this song is for you. all three of you.
Father, Son, and Father, Son, and you, Holy Ghost. We couldn't forget about you.
Bold choice, honestly, to have Eminem on this song.
Isn't he a Christian?
Is he Christian?
I think. I'm gonna look this. Most M fans seem to be in denial, but Eminem is a Christian and has religious beliefs.
Wow.
The steps of AA, which M has been in for over 11 years now, are heavy on the religious higher power God aspect. So he's a soft Christian.
Soft.
A non-practicing Christian. To the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I hold you nearest, my best friend. Let the trumpets blow with your appearance, and you know who's here.
That's so cool. Actually, I really like that echo.
The echo kind of gives it a sort of, you know how it's like Father, Son, and Holy Spirit?
Mm-hmm.
God can be like this kind of invisible sort of thing that's watching over you. So the echo kind of gives it that kind of paranormal. I don't know if that's the right word. Is that the right word? That feel though, that kind of like mystical, I don't know if I'm using the right wording for it. That vibe to it, yeah, the religious vibe true. To it.
My best friend, I know why it's so satisfying to my ear now. It's because my best friend hits all the drum beats. It's like my best friend,
because the drum hits in three.
Yeah, it hits in three, like a quiet one. Da, da, da. It's like da, 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 da. And then it's
my
like
my best friend. My yeah, best every friend. Word starts with it. Dope.
Friend. And then the second best hits on the snare. So it's like every one of my bet, like the my best friend is on the like the kick drum, and then the second best is on the snare. We'll play it again.
Yeah,
it's easier to hear it than it is to explain. Yeah. To the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I hold you nearest, my best friend. Let the trumpets blow with your appearance, and you know who's here with you, my best friend. Will you wish me hell upon my soul and spirit? Behold these lyrics, I got a best friend. Yeah, I got a best friend. Yellowwolf's got some, like, not wordplay bars, but his rhyming scheme, like, Holy Spirit, hold you nearest, your appearance, my soul and spirit.
Yeah, true.
Behold these lyrics.
Woo! Like, the whole chorus!
Yeah, I can almost hear it, like,
Holy Spirit,
yeah,
hold you the whole
yeah, whole that's kind of dope, that's kind of fire.
Everything that didn't rhyme said my best friend.
Yeah, literally, so, like, that extract rhyme. That out, yeah. It's like a rhyme, he's kind of... kind of fire.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
That line hits so good to the Father, Son, and I think to the Father, Son, I don't know why, but that kind of, it kind of sounds like you're playing drums, doesn't it? To the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
You're right, yeah.
Like, he's playing the drums with his mouth. That's kind of dope.
Eminem does that a lot.
Yeah. They definitely work together on this song, I feel. When lyrics can sound like an instrument, I'm such a sucker for that. That's so dope. Yeah, I don't know much about holy Bibles, but I grew up in the Bible Belt. I put my love over born in the night, because I got beat with my mama's belt. But I learned from my mistakes, try hard to respect people for what they believe in. But if you spit on my fucking grave and wish me hell, then I wish you well. I'ma send you straight up to my best.
Everywhere. Yo, Yellowwolf's coming with the heat.
Damn.
I'm gonna send you to my best friend. Like, I'm
like, gonna kill you.
Yeah, like, such a creative way of saying, like, yo, I'm gonna end your life.
I'm trying to look up what belt, what Bible belt.
Bible means. Belt? What is that?
It says, the Bible belt is a term used
to. Can I guess?
Oh, sorry. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, try.
I don't know if I'm gonna get it. Okay, when I heard of that, I was like, I grew up on the Bible belt. What I'm getting is, like, is a Bible belt, like, the. Fit like belts hold your pants up, so it's like the belt is like the edge of the book, like that's holding the covers together. So it's like grew up on the Bible belt, like all the pages and
oh, that's cool. But you're so far off, it's almost hilarious.
You even humored me a little. You're like, oh yeah.
That's, oh wow, you're really close actually, but you're not at all whatsoever.
What is it? Oh my you're like God. Attentively listening. Oh, yeah.
Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, the Bible Belt is a term used to describe a region in Southern America where socially conservative evangelist Protestantism plays a big role in society and politics.
Okay, that makes sense. So, it's like the location.
Yeah, the location of like...
That's like the South, kind of?
Yeah.
That's extremely religious, like...
Yeah, yeah.
Put my love for a woman on idol. I thought he was going to be like, to give you the love or some shit like that. Like, I'm not loving this woman to... But then
I think it's like, I almost makes me sound like he didn't have sex with this girl.
Oh,
because it was like against
that could be the Bible as well, yeah. Shit. Put my love for a woman on idol. Like, I put it on hold. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm not. Because I got beat with my mama's belt, so it might be what you're saying. Because the mom is like, yo, don't sin.
Yeah.
Like, don't sin. So he's like, I didn't have sex until marriage because I had the shit beat out of me as a kid.
Oh, like, shit. Try hard to respect the people for what they believe in.
I like that line. I was going to talk about that line because that's kind of a dope line, because what I'm getting is like, if you don't believe maybe the same religion as me, it's like, I'll still respect your beliefs.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you disrespect me.
Like, yeah. Like, if you spit on my fucking grave, that's what he said.
There's a difference between being like, we believe in different things and, yo, your opinion sucks shit. Like, what the fuck are you talking about? Or like, hating on someone.
If you wish me hell, then I'll wish you well as I send you to my best friend. That's sick.
That's kind of crazy because I thought it was, again, it's like a misdirect, because I thought he was going to be like, if you wish me well, then I'll wish you, or if you wish me hell, I'll wish you well. So it's like, I'll be the bigger man, like I won't, but then it's like, I'll send you right to my, so it's like, oh.
Because it's like, I won't judge you, but I'll kill you and let him judge you.
Wish me hell,
you'll end up in hell. Like,
that's kind of fire.
That's the, you know what, this is the first like song I think I've ever heard of Yellow Wolf, and so far I'm a fan.
I'm a fan for sure, yeah. Thank you for the suggestion.
Dope.
But if you spit on my fucking grave and wish me hell, then I wish you well, I'ma send you straight up to my best friend.
The chorus just has like a, it has like a progression feel to it, because it feels like it's growing and growing and growing, and like would you consider it like orchestral almost?
Yeah,
it's like,
yeah, for sure.
Getting like, louder and louder, and
there is definitely like some powerful strings coming in here.
That's a perfect word to describe it, because it's mirroring the idea of like God being like the best friend, like the power behind the music is like the power behind. When you said that, that's like the perfect word. Powerful is like
delicious.
Want to eat these bars up? Chocolate bar. Oh, I'm not ready for this.
Is it long?
Oh, it is pretty. Yeah, but like long. But like, it's also Eminem too, so I'm like, and people
said this is his best verse, like after what was it, Caterpillar, and after All I Think About,
I think top notch. Like, that's gonna be hard to beat.
That is gonna be hard. But you said it. This is you, all of you people,
especially you.
This one, you. You all said this was his best verse, and I'm so psyched to hear it. All
right, here we go.
I like the fact that you guys are putting the trust in us to actually like try to catch this shit. I'm so nervous.
This is our first time hearing this, so like, we're not Superman, you know? Like, we're gonna miss some shit, but like,
so nervous. But this is a team effort.
Yeah, including you guys, catch the shit that we don't get, you know?
And wish me hell, then I wish you well, I'ma send you straight up to my best friend. To the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Talk about one of our favorite things about like rap songs and breaking this stuff down is people passing it to like other people.
Yeah.
He passed it to himself. It was like a self alley-oop into the chorus. And he's like, I'm gonna send you straight up to my best friend.
Oh, you're right.
That was so sick.
I feel like I usually only realize it because it's someone else like passing it to the
else?
Yeah. So when he did do it to himself, that's fire.
Self alley-oop. It was like you take a basketball, you hit it off the backboard, and then you dunk it.
Yeah, man.
I kind of hurt. I hit the one. The ceiling.
Yeah, I got a best friend, best friend. Yeah.
God, please, would you arm me with the arm of the call me when it's drama? Like Gandhi, could have gone the other way many times, could have turned Dali with the llama. But I squash my beefs and things seem to be looking decent recently, but don't jinx it. It's like Clint Eastwood looking for peace, though maybe not finna interrupt the priesthood, but at least should make an attempt to show some remorse in it.
This is gonna be one of those.
Yeah, it's gonna be one of those.
Finding a hard. Oh man, God, please arm me with the army.
That flow is. Please arm me, but like army also like army, like yes. Give me an army.
Yes, arm me with the armor to calm me when there's drama, like Gandhi.
Like what Gandhi. Is
that? Army, armor. Wait. No, there's two rhyme schemes there. Army, the army, and the arma rhyme.
Army,
scheme. Army. Yeah. Arma. Oh. Army with the arma. Call me with the drama. Oh, Gandhi.
Right.
Could have Gandhi. Oh my god. Gandhi could have Gandhi.
There's drama. Gandhi could have Gandha. Could have turned Dali with the llama. Llama is like gun. And you hear like a gunshot go off too. What does Dali mean?
Dalai Lama.
Could have turned Dali with the llama.
Like the Dalai Lama.
Yeah, but like what does Dali mean? Is that like a meaning? Or is he just saying like I could have turned peaceful with the. With the peace. Speaking of peace, by the way, like Clint Eastwood looking for a peace though.
Llama is slang for gun, which comes from the Spanish. Comes from the name of a Spanish arms company. What the hell? I've never heard that before. I don't think I'll ever hear it again. Could have turned Dolly with the llama. Oh, that's cool. Like Dalai Lama was like a super peaceful guy, right? Do you think you could have turned him into not a peaceful guy if you just gave him a gun?
Could have turned Dali with... Oh, I could have turned Dali, yeah. Like turned the Dalai Lama with a llama, like with a gun. Like I could have turned him... Yeah, you're right. But I squashed my beef and things seem to be looking decently recently. Clint Eastwood looking for the peace though. Clint Eastwood gun.
Peace gun, yes.
Gandhi, army, Dali.
That's cool that he used, like, he could have said Gandhi, but he said Gandha for the other Gandhi, rhyme.
Yeah. Gandhi and Gandhi.
Yeah, he could have used it for one rhyme, but he used it for the other. But
he's also saying, like, God, give me, like, the strength to fight, because, like, I could have turned to violence, but I didn't. I squashed my beef and things seemed to look... So he, like, kind of put his wars aside, kind of, is the vibe I'm getting.
Oh, you think right? this whole verse is, like, a prayer?
Maybe he's talking about, like, yeah.
This so might, far, it sounds like
might
a prayer.
Be. But that's kind of the vibe I'm getting is, like, yo, God help me with this, because, like, I've squashed the beef. Like, I'm done with it. I could have turned to violence, but I didn't. Could have gone the other way many times to calm me when there's drama like Gandhi. So, like, yeah, that's the vibe I'm getting.
Looking decent recently, but don't jinx it. Ah. Looking decent recent. That flow switch was weird.
Yeah.
One more time?
Yeah, one more time. Yeah, please would you arm me with the arm to call me when it's drama like Gandhi. Could have Gandhi other way many times, could have turned Dali with the llama. But I squash my beef, some things seem to be looking decent recently, but don't jinx it. It's like Clint Eastwood looking for peace, though maybe not finna enter the priesthood, but at least should make an attempt to show some remorse and to be some sort of repenter for the people. I've been a minister, not a preacher, but a shit starter and finisher. Inner the mind of a thick skin, but a short tipper. This patience of mine is thinner than twine is winner. Get a text, or I might say something back that might offend you. So if you don't like when I rap,
we have to stop it somewhere. No,
bro,
so
just
much.
Before I forget, did you hear? It sounded like he said minister, but he said minister. But minister, you... minister, like priesthood, like...
Yeah.
Like being a minister.
I heard minister.
For the people, I've been a minister. But like menace to, I've been a menace to. Like
menace to, yeah. Oh, I heard minister.
Yeah, I heard minister as well, but he says menace to. So
not like, a preacher, but a shit starter and finisher. Oh, shit. I start shit and finish it.
Oh. He's not going to turn to priesthood. Like, he's not going to go, he's already going to hell. Like, he's not going to turn to like that kind of, is the vibe I'm getting. Like, he's not going to be, like, I'm not going to, the odds of me, like, godliness next to cleanliness.
Oh yeah.
Like how would it be that I'm beside myself, like that whole thing?
Wild. Yeah.
From fucking Alfred's theme.
Good memory. I like the little interior rhymes he did, like the back to back, like
yeah.
The priesthood.
Finna. That's the difference between using a word like gonna and finna.
Yeah.
Like, finna. Again.
True. But he could have said gonna too. Gonna inna.
Gonna.
Inna. It wouldn't have sounded the same. Finna.
This patience of mine is thinner than a twine. Than a twine is when I.
Then twine is when. Twine. I...
Also, menace to. That's kind of like to these people. I'm a menace to. That's, I just want to put a spotlight on that line because he's saying, on one end, to the people who hate him, like the people who find him offensive, he's been a menace to, because like he's just offending them. They call him a menace because he's like causing chaos and shit, poisoning the minds of the youth. To these other people, he's been a minister. Like he's been preaching these words that he says in his rhymes and like saying it.
Oh, wow.
But like he's saying both those things in one bar.
That's
and
crazy.
I think that's. Dope
priesthood, but
Clint Eastwood.
I like that one line where he says, this patience of mine is thinner than twine is when I get it, like, than when I, right? But I like the pause he added to make it go with the flow. It was like if you were just to like say it, you'd say, this patience of mine is thinner than twine when I, whatever. But he goes, this patience of mine is thinner than twine is when I, like,
yeah,
that's so
yeah.
sick.
And when I doesn't rhyme with thinner,
no,
but he is like. Mine is thinner than twine is winner. like, yeah, he like so forced sick. It. He like takes the English language and like Plato and just like, look what I made.
Yeah, you're still technically the word. Yeah. You're still Plato. Yeah. Your
ears pick it up, you know? Exactly. Have you ever seen those, I think it's called like abstract art where it's just kind of like blotches, but those blotches kind of, when you stand far away, it kind of creates an image in your brain. You're like, oh, I see a face, like it's a woman.
Oh yeah.
Eminem is the lyrical version of that. Where, like, the sounds your brain picks them up, they're like, okay, I see what you're saying. I know what you're saying.
This is facts, bro. That's actually so true.
Like, he does that for your ears.
Not a preacher, but a shit scholar and finish up into the mind of a thick skin, but a short tipper. This patience of mine is thinner than twine is when I get a text, so I might say something back that might offend you. So if you don't like when I rap, I'm gonna have to say on the mic, then you might wanna act just like quarterbacks and take a fucking hike when I snap, cause I'm a sinner.
So much. He adds the little, takes parts of what you did. Like when he's doing a feature, he'll take parts of what you did and then use them.
Another reference is in our Nat video, one of us pointed out that he does like the DA got that dope has the beat, but then he goes DA got that dope. He sends to me, yes. Like he connects it. Does a similar thing here. I'm a sinner and I got a, and then you hear
it. Yes, right.
He doesn't even say it. It's Yellow. Oh, it Yellow says it. Yeah. It's got that echo in it too.
Oh yeah. The
quarterback.
Quarterback line. Yes.
Take a hike. What is snap? Like, is that
it's the same? Like you could say like hike, you could say snap, but it's like the same shit. It's like the
take a hike when I snap. Yeah. But snap also means like when I lose my temper, which goes back to earlier where he's like, I got a short temper. My patience of mine is thinner. See, also, if you kind of take the whole thing in the beginning where he was talking about like, yo, y'all better leave me alone, like my patience is thin, here he's saying like, yo, my temper is running short, like I might say if you say something to me, I get attacked, so I might say something back, like I might retaliate. That kind of I think this was the 2015, so this is before Kamikaze, right?
Yes.
So this kind of puts you in his headspace where he's like, yo, I'm kind of having enough. So when Kamikaze comes out, that's like him when he's like, yo, like, fuck off everybody.
Yeah.
And I didn't hear anything after that. I think that's it. I mean, Genius is saying that sinner kind of like, the way he's saying it sounds like center, like I'm the center of like everybody's attention,
I guess. Is the center a position in football too, potentially?
Probably. Let me see before we sound dumb. The center is the innermost lineman of the offensive line. So
the center. All right. Yeah.
Okay. Right. Okay. So actually I'm the center of attention, but also I'm a center. Like I'm the center, like a position in football.
Dope. Take it. Thanks. Dope.
Genius.
What if we get job opportunities at Genius? Wouldn't that be sick? Wouldn't that be so sick?
Hey guys, this YouTube thing's over. We're doing...
Oh, man. If anybody knows anyone who works at Genius...
We could do better than this, I think.
I think so too. Like, we got this.
So if you don't like when I rap, I'm gonna have to say on the mic, then you might wanna act just like quarterbacks and take a fucking hike when I snap, cause I'm a sinner.
I'm willing to bet that the center is the person who snaps the ball to the quarterback.
Of course it is. It has to be. Let me see. Football center. Who passes?
Who snaps it?
Yo. That was dope. Yeah. You caught that. Like, you know how you caught that too? Knowing nothing from football, just being like, what kind of person is Eminem?
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly right, like, bro.
Okay, well, if Eminem's the person I know he is, this must be
I'm willing to bet. I'm a center. I'm a center. He makes the center... like connect with the quarterback with the football scheme, and then he makes the center connect with the whole song.
So if you don't like when I rap, I'm gonna have to say on the mic, then you might wanna act just like quarterbacks and take a fucking hike when I snap, cause I'm a sinner. I don't got it. This way, my balls and intestines, and they never been yes men. They gonna tell me when I'm fucking up the minute, I'm never giving it less. Then I'm about to vomit and I can feel it coming, cause failure's something I can barely stomach, and I only listen to my guts, and unless you're my fucking belly button, don't tell me, not doing my this way.
Song, bro. Sometimes, okay. Bro, this is how I'm officially tearing apart Eminem's bars, right?
Go
as soon as
it.
I hear anything, any single thing that can connect, I'm looking for this.
Yeah.
Now it's like intestines, guts, bro. Stomach, and it also,
he says center plus balls and intestines. The people around me, they've never been yes men. Like, they're not just like, yeah, Marshall, good job. Like, that's a good song.
True. Yeah, I guess he's talking about, like, I don't know, like, you know, D12, like Slaughterhouse.
Yeah. Probably good people. But then the whole rhyming scheme you were gonna say, it's like, I'm about to vomit. Failure's something I can barely stomach, and I only listen to my gut.
Oh, so unless you're my fucking belly button, don't tell me nothing.
Nothing? Like balls?
Like balls.
I only listen to my gut. So if, unless you're my belly button, don't tell me anything. Because I only listen to my gut.
That's all I listen to.
So unless you're a part of my gut, like, don't tell me anything.
Unless you're literally my gut.
Gut, yeah.
Don't tell me
shit.
That's sick. I want to see if we actually did better than Genius this time.
Yeah.
I want to see. Because if we did, Genius, you have 24 hours to respond. Eminem creates an extended metaphor by playing around with the intestines, stomach, gut, belly button, his balls, and his intestines. Always let him know when he messes up. Everything he does on his intuitions and doesn't care for what others may have to say. Don't tell me nothing. You ain't my best friend. Best friend.
Yeah,
then he passes it
yo,
again.
He uses it twice then.
Yeah.
Like, and I got a best friend because you ain't my best friend. Yeah. Like using the same.
You can't tell me nothing. You ain't my best friend.
Oh,
now this might be a stretch that I'm about to say here, but
stretch away
yoga this bitch. do you think this might be a reference to Rap God a little bit
with what
with you ain't my best friend, like God obviously, but then it's like he only listens to his gut himself, so it's like
I am the Rap
I am God,
God,
like, why, so...
I only listen to not you. I listen to me. That is definitely a connection, because it's like I only listen to my gut, I only listen to myself, like
yeah,
Rap God. But Genius didn't give us anything new, by the way.
Nice.
Like, we got everything.
Nice, we did.
That's so proud. I'm very
proud. I feel really good about it. You guys are getting, like, you're professionals getting paid for this shit, and we're getting the exact same
stuff out of it.
Yeah, it's cool.
It's cool, too, because I would not have been this good at it, like, before this YouTube channel.
No, for sure. Yeah,
I was
you're right.
Genius.
We definitely, if we did this song first, we would not have done it justice at all.
No. I don't think we did Zeus justice,
I don't
honestly.
Think we did
yeah,
either.
Okay.
Zeus, literally all our first
ones. All our first ones. Friday Night Cypher, bro. We did not give that
no!
the credit it deserves. Like,
let us know if you'd like us to redo the videos we've already done, but better. Because, you know, we're better at this now.
No, okay, I'll say this. If we get to 2,000 subs, so almost there, we'll react to Bad Guy by Eminem.
Do you think
first
we get
video.
Copyright strike if we react to our own video? Which still has, like, the copyright shit in it, but, like...
We could try.
Then I'm about to vomit and I can feel it coming to stay.
I can feel it coming, don't tell me nothing.
Coming,
nothing, bang. So there's kind of two, like, body part schemes going on at the same time. There's, like, the intestines part, and then there's the balls part. He says, plus balls. Oh, yeah, because he goes, plus balls and intestines. And then the balls part goes, balls, I can feel it coming, don't tell me nothing. Like, busting a nut.
That's like a little mini scheme.
Yeah,
within
mini scheme within
yeah.
a scheme, yeah. And then he goes, intestines, I'm about to vomit. Something I can't stomach. I only listen to my gut.
Also, another rhyming scheme, it's a little further back that I want to point out. I'm a huge fan of rhyming where it's like word, word, rhyme, word, word, rhyme in the first bar. And then the second bar is word, 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 rhyme. There's like two of the same rhyme. And then the last bar kind of goes on for double it rhymes.
Yeah.
He does it here because he's like, plus balls and intestines. And they've never been yes men. They gonna tell me when I'm fucked up the minute I am ever given it less than.
Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
It's super dope that he's like, intestines, yes, man, less than.
Yeah,
like, that's
yeah,
dope.
Yeah.
That's dope.
I do like that.
He holds those two syllables longer than all the other words, like, da-da-da-da-da, and then
less
holds
than.
Them out, you know?
And I've never been yes, man. They gonna tell me when I'm fucking up the minute, I'm never given it less than. I'm about to vomit and I can feel it coming, cause failure's yeah, something I can barely stomach, and I only listen to my guts, and unless you're my fucking belly button, don't tell me.
I didn't even hear a word he said after
the sheep thing.
They tend to flock like shepherds. The black sheep, like black sheep is like the they're the black sheep of the family. They're like the standout, right, or something like that. But flock like shepherds, call them sheep. It'll be the worst thing that these motherfuckers ever heard. Like heard like music wise, but heard like a shepherd
like
herds
the sheep.
Sheep.
Yes, like a shepherd to
yeah.
sheep.
Yeah. Oh, there's also a choir in the background. It's like.
He had me focused on that, so I didn't hear lyrics at
all.
We'll go back.
Luckily, Alusha, we got the lyrics in here.
Still got a best friend.
Shout it out.
It's almost like a little mini chorus in there, but like Eminem's
kind of,
version.
Yeah. Also, I mean, we got to point out the, like, there's never been a louder mouth. Should have never been a louder mouth. like a loud a mouth. Like yes. you shouldn't, if you're not going to use your mouth to speak on, I'll make it more vague than just like religion. If you're not going to use your mouth to speak on what you believe in or like what you think, like you shouldn't even be allowed a mouth. It's like a privilege to be able to speak up for yourself.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I forget the song, but it was like, if you ain't standing up for yourself, stay seated. That fucking
yeah, line. Yeah, yeah.
What were you going to say?
Actually, Hobson just came out with the song, and in that it's like, you don't even deserve a brain. Give me it.
Yeah. Oh. Now I got a higher power, like God, higher power. Now, when I black out, power outage. Like,
here's another scheme, bro.
Yeah. They're powerless, but the crowd's around, and then it goes into the herd.
Okay. Power, blackout, mm-hmm. power outage, powerless, crowd around, tend to flock, sheep. You think Belly Button did something about that? Like, he says Belly Button, and then goes from button to like the power scheme.
Oh, that's okay. That could actually definitely be a connection for sure. Like, it's Eminem, of course. Yeah, it is.
For sure. It's maybe a stretch, but
also, no. The whole sheep thing that and shepherd, like, that's very religious and biblical as well.
So
he's still
right.
Kind of keeping the religious theme. You're my best friend. That's the thing, when you have Eminem on a track, he's gonna utilize, if the song's already made, the production's there, he'll not only improve it, but he'll rewrite his verse to fit, like, the song. He really is, like, a producer as well as, like, the artist, you know?
True. I'm sorry, but Geese got, like, the worst fucking sound of all time. Why? That's so ugly. This is disgusting. Honestly, I'm
repulsive.
Like, I'm so sorry.
Either stay quiet or bark.
Why a honk?
It's not like a mating sound.
Yeah, there's no good good reason for a goose to be like
honking.
You'll never hear a goose honk and it not be like, oh, what's wrong? What's wrong?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
It's always there's something wrong.
Before we go on, the whole like Eminem kind of letting the chorus take over,
mm-hmm.
it kind of fits, I think, because it's kind of believable to me that it's like this disembodied voice that's supporting the lyrics that he's saying. So it really feels like God's got his back, you know. You know what I mean?
Yes! You even said that earlier too, guys!
Yeah, I just clicked now. It's like, oh, it kind of sounds like he's like, yo, God, take it over,
yes,
man.
Yes, that's sick.
Yo, he's playing lyrical wordplay with the big guy upstairs.
That's
you
so
know?
Sick. I'm willing to bet no one else caught that. That's so sick.
My soul's in intestines, and it never been yes, man. They can tell me when I'm fucking up the meaning, I'm never giving it less than I'm about to vomit, and I can feel it coming, cause tell you something I can bear. My stomach, and I only listen to my guts, and unless you're my fucking belly button, don't tell me, not doing my
scheme we didn't even talk about.
Which one?
He goes, you should say feel it coming, but he goes, fail it coming, fail is nothing or something, barely stomach.
Listen, yeah.
Unless you're my belly button, don't tell me nothing.
Yeah.
That's sick.
Belly button.
Yes.
Tell me nothing.
Fail it coming. Fail
it coming. Barely stomach.
Yeah. Like,
bro, how did we miss that?
That's crazy.
Yo, he took the word belly button and rhymed like it. That's
belly button
super
definitely
dope.
Came first.
The whole, that's a cool way of saying it. Like, I'm about to vomit because I feel it coming because failure is something that I can barely stomach. Like, even the thought of failure is like making him like wretch.
Yeah.
That's kind of a very, like, the imagery.
But I feel like we've all been there before, though.
Like, feeling like anxiety.
Yeah,
like
you ever been, like,
this
ready
could
to
not
run?
Work out.
You ever been ready to, like, run a race or something, like track and field or whatever, and then it's like, you're just nervous, you're literally about to puke. It's
yeah.
I think that's, like, that feeling
or,
right there.
Before you present something, and you're like, is something where it's, like, essentially where you're in front of a crowd, or, like, people are watching, and it's like, whoa, if I mess up, I can't, you know. When realistically, I just thought of something when you said that. We only do it when we're around people. Because if I mess up in front of myself, I'll be like, oh, it's okay.
Yeah.
But also, that's what I would do if you messed up as well. I'd be like, oh, it's, you know, happens. But to ourselves, we're like, when people are watching, you know?
It's the end of my world.
But even though those people are probably going to be like,
they'll never remember that.
Yeah.
They'll never remember that.
Weird. Like, we'll remember that.
Yeah.
Though.
Wow.
That's kind of crazy.
Who do you think I'm talking about? Piss me up when I'm down and I still look to him without a doubt. I still got a piss.
Do you hear like the beat like
the first time it did that was right before it said powerless.
Is
dope.
Like blackout power outage.
Powerless.
So it's like you kind of, you know when your TV turns off, it's like
yes.
Kind of does that, but then comes back with like a vengeance.
Powerless.
Power outage. Ow.
Now that I got a higher power, now when I black out, power outage. Powerless, but they crowd around. They tend to flock like shepherds. The black sheep, but I'll be the worst thing that these motherfuckers ever heard. When I'm counting out, you'll be D-O-A. They'll announce or pronounce you dead.
when he said surrounded, when it surrounds you now, or surrounds you now, yeah. Like, his voice was kind of...
Yeah, kind of going around. Back and the blow was behind us.
Really?
And he goes, blow! And it's, like, way back there. It's just literally surround sound.
It's moments like this where I'm glad we're, like, listening to it in a car. Yeah. When I'm counted out, you'll be DOA, like, dead on arrival. They'll announce, but pronounce you dead when they sound it out. Going back to the original beginning, like, he's saying he's put all the beef aside, but people keep pushing him. He's about to snap because his patience is running thin. And then here he's, like, I guess turning to how much power he has. It's like, don't even come at me. It's kind of what I'm getting, because he's gloating kind of a little bit. He's like, look at how much power I have now.
You'll be DOA, they'll announce, pronounce you dead when they sound it out. What do you mean by when they sound it out? Which is a synonym for the...
Pronounce, sound it out.
Yeah.
Pronounce, sound it out, that's dope.
Yeah, that makes sense. When I'm counting out, you'll be DOA, they'll announce, but pronounce you dead when they sound it out. So prepare for arrival, your arch enemy surrounds you now, he's all around you. Not even the doctors at the hospital are gonna shaky shock you back to life. Is it piggy possible to revive you? That's hard to do. You got sticky stuff, and it's not an option. Something I'm not gonna do. I'm the Iggy Pop of hip hop when I walk in the booth. Dog on the truth like Biggie rocking with Tupac. And a soup talk in the proof. Dropping a deuce, fill up a syllable clip like a refillable strip cock. And I shoot. Who do you think's my clock that I use that I pull? Jeez, bro. Do you hear that? It's like a synthesizer, like electric, high pitch thing that's kind of building up and building up. It kind of adds like a layer to it. Oh, I think something we missed in the back here. It's like, I'll be the worst thing that these motherfuckers ever heard, like literally heard. Mm-hmm. And then he goes, announce, pronounce, sound it out. So all these like,
sound it out, the pronounce. Hearing. Yeah, that is 100% like
and a surrounds you a now. Sound. Oh, he says all these like
the hearing surrounds scheme, you now,
and then surrounds you now. He literally like makes like a
surrounds you, yeah,
like a surround
around you. Wow.
Yes,
I do like this is kind of a cool rhyme because are you not even the doctors are gonna shiggy shock you, piggy possible, diggy doc, stiggy stomping, Iggy pop, like Iggy Azalea. Is that what he's talking
yeah,
about?
Yeah, Iggy Pop of hip-hop. She did nothing to him, and he's just like, I just don't like you. Yeah. What's with this whole shiggy, piggy, diggy, stiggy thing?
Don't know. Let's see what Genius has to say. Can't figure it out. Oh, Iggy Pop is the frontman of a proto-punk band in the Stooges. So it's not Iggy.
Oh, whoops.
Cut that part out. That's a cool...
Diggy, diggy, doc.
Diggy, doc, piggy, poss, Iggy Pop. Biggie Rock.
He's shouting out the doc, the Diggy Diggy Doc, a creative force behind the NWA
band. Those boys. One of the best boy bands of all time, NWA.
Don't even call him a boy band. You know how much hate you're gonna get? So so the Piggy, Iggy, Stiggy thing is like a
set of schemes.
It's like a scheme, I guess. Because Diggy Diggy Doc and Iggy Pop.
Iggy Pop, Diggy Doc, Piggy,
those just
Poss,
rhyme on
Shiggy
those.
Shock, Biggie Rock.
Oh, you're just going hard on that then.
Yeah.
Ah, cool.
If we're missing something, comment it below.
Yeah.
Let us know.
You think blow means something?
Yeah, gunshot.
Oh, well, fair.
You mean other like, than a gunshot? Yeah.
Then there's the hospital scheme. Not even the doctors at the hospital are going to sticky shock you back to life. I'm Piggy Possible. Oh, I'm Piggy Possible.
Piggy
to
possible.
Revive you. Oh, that's cool. Then he's going all
on
hospital.
Oh,
here it is.
Doctors, hospital, D-Doc, they're going to shiggy shock you back to life.
Oh, damn.
Almost missed that hospital scheme.
Okay.
But that synthesizer, though, that like comes in hard. Talking to Proof, dropping a deuce. Proof died. Like his friend Proof.
Notorious B.I.G., Tupac, and Proof are all deceased rappers. All of them.
Oh, so he's doing a thing on deceased rappers.
So, Eminem suggests that they hung out in heaven. There's nothing realer than three fallen soldiers meeting in the afterlife. Oh, that image though. They dap each other up and all dressed in white. That's sick. I'm the truth, like Biggie Rock with Tupac in a suit. Talking to Proof, dropping a deuce. So you can tell this is kind of the end of his verse because like he does this a lot. He'll just pay a lot of homage right at the end. He's like shouting out people. Like
at
the end, he'll like shouted out the Doc, Iggy Pop, Tupac, Notorious B.I.G. Proof.
Bro, fill up a syllable clip like a refillable script, cock it and shoot it, and who you think's my Glock that I use, that I pull from to get my strength up against these haters.
It's my best friend.
And I'll be waiting here at the gate when you get sprayed up, sending you hoes straight up to deal with my best friend. So it's kind of a harder bar than Yellow Wolf's.
Yeah, well,
so
listen to it again, and then that's
it. Friend. When I'm counting out, you'll be DOA, they'll announce and pronounce you dead when they sound it out. So prepare for arrival, your arch enemy surrounds you now, he's all around you. Not even the doctors at the hospital are gonna shiggy shock you back to life. Is it piggy possible to revive you? That's hard to dig, you got sticky stuff, and it's not an option. Something I'm not gonna do. I'm the Iggy Pop of hip hop when I walk in the booth. Dog on the truth like Biggie rocking with Tupac. And a soup talk in the proof. Dropping a deuce, fill up a syllable clip like a refillable strip cock. And a shoot. Who do you think's my clock that I use that I pull from to get my strength up against these haters? And we'll be waiting at the gate when you get sprayed up, sitting you home straight up to deal with my.
Son, and Holy Spirit.
Rhymes,
fucking, yeah, okay, let's talk about the rhymes and play that part over again. I don't give a fuck about, like, I want to hear that part again. That fucking bass drop goes into
okay, I'm down.
The
chorus. The sound is oof. The sound that he's rhyming with is oof. Talking to proof, dropping to doof, deuce, syllable crip, talking to
shoot.
Talking
to shoot.
Glock that I use.
Cock it and shoot. Glock that I use. Drop in a deuce. So it's four syllables.
Oh, so it is four syllables. Wow, I missed that.
Drop in a deuce. Cock it and shoot. Glock that I use.
See, that's an example right there. A couple videos ago, we were like, yeah, he's using the, like, you're looking for the last syllable, but there's also the interior rhymes. And I literally just fell a victim to that. Because I was like, ooh, the oof sound is so hard. And I literally missed everything else.
Well, in this sense, it, you know, there's just so much there. Like, I feel like we went back and, like, missed a lot of shit that we had to go back and mention.
Yeah,
so
you're right.
This was a tough one.
Oh, my God. It goes way back to, I walk in the booth.
No.
Walk in the booth.
And I'm not gonna
Tupac in a suit.
Before that, I'm not gonna do.
Wow. I'm still scrolling.
Yeah. Something I'm not gonna do. Walk in the booth. Dog, I'm the truth.
Oh.
Tupac in a suit. Dropping a deuce. Oh, he's been going.
Dropping a deuce.
That's a good rhyming scheme.
I can't even say that.
Yeah. Fill up a syllable clip like a refillable script.
He's very creative. Like, he's so creative. He says a lot of the same stuff over again. But he says, like, he'll find different ways to say it. It's like, good luck. Like, any regular rapper, good luck finding a creative way to say it one time. And he'll say it over and over again in a different way. So sick.
What you're saying within this song, he's proven that. Because Yellow Wolf says, like, if you hate on me or if you spit on my grave, I'll send you to my best friend. He essentially says that same thing, but he words it differently.
Oh,
so he's saying the same thing within the same song, but, like, new.
Play it again.
Not even the doctors at the hospital are gonna shiggy shock you back to life. Is it piggy possible to revive you? That's hard to dig your gas, diggy stop, and it's not an option. Something I'm not gonna do. I'm the Iggy Pop of hip hop when I walk in the booth. Dog on the truth, like Biggie rocking with Tupac in a suit. Talking to proof, dropping a deuce, fill up a syllable clip like a refillable strip cock and a shoot. Who do you think's my clock that I use that I pull from to get my strength up against these haters? And they'll be waiting at the gate when you get sprayed. I'm sitting you home straight as to do with my best friend. To the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I hold you nearest. My best friend. Let the trumpets blow with your appearance. You don't lose hearing. My best friend. When you wish me hell upon my soul and spirit, behold these lyrics. I got a best friend.
Wow, first time hearing that song. Woo! That hook was fire.
That was good.
Like, I never got tired of hearing that.
Oh, pretty much every single time the hook came out, they passed it to the hook.
Yeah. Oh, I'll send you right to my. Now, I have a question for you. This might make some people mad. Compare this to All I Think About. Which one did you like more?
Honestly, I like, oh man. Okay, musically, obviously this one. Yeah, All I Think About, garbage on a plate. I hated that.
So, production-wise,
yeah.
Have you listened to it since?
I have, yeah.
And it hasn't grown on you?
I don't hate it as much now.
Okay.
But production-wise, I'm still not a fan. Because it's not a good beat. Like, I don't know what to tell you.
But this one you like.
This one is amazing, yeah. Okay, like, okay. But bars-wise, I still think I like All I Think
All
about.
All I Think
better.
About?
Yeah.
I agree with you wholeheartedly. Like, I think the music in this was a lot better. I think the hook was amazing.
Oh, yeah.
This was a crazy song to react to. I had my doubts after All I Think About. I was like, okay. The viewers are right. Yeah,
like,
so,
this was heavily suggested after All I Think About.
I see why.
Yeah, for sure. Like, thanks, guys, for watching that video. Super dope reaction. If you have a song anywhere close to that, I'd love to hear it. Love to react to it. Comment it down below. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, because we each got our own, and then we got the channel as well. Yeah, we'll see you guys on the next video.